Hi, my love. Thank you so much for visiting.
Wow. Someone here is like very, very adamant right now about starting a life, creating a family. Like somebody here is interested in having a legacy, healing family issues, removing generational. Good grief. Two of cups, ten of cups? Who is this person? The Ten of Cups is here with the Death card and the Tower. So, something has recently happened to a person. There's been, somebody here is going through an awakening. They're seeing the truth completely about a person, a place thing, or a situation here. This feels like someone is coming out of like a dark night of the soul. Someone is realizing that like they are magical, that they are supernatural here, that someone is recognizing their purpose. The Star, the Eight of Wands is here, the Three of Cups, and the Ten of Pentacles. This also too is, there's a masculine here for some. This person has found their counterpart. Now, I don't know if you could be like the Divine Feminine watching. Someone is headed towards you. Okay, now when I say someone is headed towards you, this could be you reconciling with someone. This could be a relationship that's currently in your life that's about to go to the next level, or this could be related to someone you haven't met, but they're energetically connecting to you. You may not see this coming. The Four of Cups here, now the feminine energy. Yeah, you don't see this coming. There's a huge, huge change that's bringing justice here. Somebody, oh yes. There's a masculine here who has been manifesting a life with you. You and this person may have shared a past life. I'm getting right off the bat, somebody here is hiding the fact that they are gifted. Someone here has hidden the fact that they're gifted, or they recently came into some type of gifts. This person knows something about you, about your life, your past life. They know something. This energy is way too strong. Yeah, the Two of Cups here. And this is very strong here. This devil energy is, I'm not picking up toxic, but I'm picking up like somebody has a very, very strong desire for you to the point now, like, they have a lot of passion for you, for sure. You're healing, okay? Or you have helped heal this person, possibly. This person has become addicted to you, and I feel like there's a masculine here who's becoming almost addicted to the idea of them going into union with a feminine here. Whoever the Divine Feminine is, you're happy, you're successful. You don't really see this coming. I feel like you and someone may be separated, or you're in this mode of you're going with the flow. You don't see something coming here. This could be someone who, yeah, victory, success, rewards, recognition, moving on to peaceful, calmer waters, stability, security, love. Oh my gosh. You do not see this coming. You do not see this person rushing towards you. You could be stressed out, having fear, anxiety, sleepless nights. You could be a hopeless romantic. You don't know exactly what's going to happen. Some of you, this is so strange. I'm getting a lot of this energy, though. Some of you, I'm seeing this. I'm not to ruin a surprise. Some of you, someone is going to propose to you when you least expect it. It's not going to be anything grandiose, but somebody, like, they may propose to you just... You may wake up with a ring on your finger. Whoever, like, this energy is someone, they're not taking no for an answer. This is love today. Someone is not taking no for an answer. You may wake up with like a ring on your finger, or you may just be in the house, in the car. This person may just pull out a ring. For some of you, I'm seeing for somebody, they may not even have a ring, but it's so weird. This looks like something I've seen in a movie before. But I haven't. I don't think I have. Well, I'm seeing two different situations because I'm seeing proposals. I'm seeing a person standing in the kitchen and somebody comes in and they're just like, I think we should get married. And you don't, like, this person is very, very serious. I'm also seeing for some of you with these cards, you could be in your sleep. You could be sleeping with someone, like just in the bed with this person. You may overhear them talking about planning a proposal, or while they maybe you're in a light sleep, this person is going to say that they love you, or they may say, I can't wait until we can spend the rest of our lives together. Someone here is about to make it clear that they want to spend their life with you. I don't know who this may be a reading today for one person. I don't know because it's very, very specific. There's a masculine here who is thinking about marriage. Non-stop. This devil card here, this person has gifts. I feel like somebody here has the gift. They could be, I'm not like they could be psychic, but I don't even know what it's called, but it's almost like this. I feel like there's a masculine out here who has very strong it's something here with telepathy. This person can practically read your thoughts. I don't know if this person can read energy or read thoughts or both. Yeah, this person is an energy reader somehow. Oh, they can read palms too. There's a masculine out here, you guys, who has been hiding the fact that they are gifted. This person, they already know you from a past life. If it's not a past life, you've crossed paths with this person at some point in your life. And it's like from the very beginning, they always knew it was you, or they knew that they will come back into contact with you. If you're not in contact or communication with this person, they already knew. They were planning or strategizing. But this person here has made up their mind. With the Justice card and the Ace of Swords, but I'm telling you, this person is also sending you some type of telepathic communication. I don't know, this person, they know something. They know something about you. They just know something about your lives together. This person here. This person, I feel, dibbles and dabbles with some type of manifestation work. I don't know what it is. Now, I'll be honest, they could be into like candle magic or something like that. Herbs, candle magic. This person could be very familiar with the chakras. For some of you, though, I'm getting where this person. I'm picking up a masculine here who is just natural. They were born with some very strong gifts. But they've recently gone through a transformation that has activated something. This feels like somebody just woke up with superpowers. I'm hearing like like the movie Dr. Dolittle. He could hear animals talking. This person could be a like a medium or something. Yeah. This person is like, where is this stuff coming from? They're receiving downloads and but they're receiving downloads about you. I had a reading maybe within the last 6 months. And I talked about a divine feminine and masculine exchanging gifts with one another. And there's another reading where it was like spinal infusion. This is like some type of kundalini awakening, or it's the energy of two people merging together. So if you have spiritual psychic gifts and this person has them, now that the two of you are within like close proximity to one another, especially if you haven't met them, it's activating. if this person is in your life because of the energetic shifts that we're experiencing, whatever blockages have been delaying you and this person from spiritually growing, tapping into your own gifts, from coming into union with yourself so that you're able to come into a physical union with one another, that's being removed. So for some of you, you and someone both are mirroring each other, but there's an activate, there's a soul activation here where there's gifts. Like, this is something that is destined. It's exactly what you manifested. And it's going to move at a very rapid rate here. The Eight of Wands is here, the Three of Cups, and the Ten of Pentacles. This is you coming into union. You and this person, you're a part of like the same soul family. You may not be. You manifested this though. 100%. This is this couple that I keep channeling. Like, it's a divine couple. The two of you, this is like a Hierophant and a High Priestess, a Hermit and a High Priestess, an Emperor and a High Priestess. You and someone, your purpose is for you to do something really amazing together. But it's interesting, this masculine, either they knew this when they met you, or they recently had a dream or some type of download, and they're like, there's something that just, it went off in this person's head and they just know. I'm really almost speechless. But this person is manifesting a lot. And I'm looking at it like, is this person just doing a lot of love magic on you? Or, well, I don't think that's what it is. I feel like someone here has been manifesting a happy life, legacy, commitment, joy, peace, prosperity, and it came in the form of a person. I'm not even joking. The roles could be reversed. Divine feminine, you could be the both of you are manifesting one another. This reading, I'm picking up the energy of a masculine. I know it's a lot of feminines who are watching, but you and someone both are manifesting a life partner, and you're connecting on a soul level. This person is being activated by you, and vice versa. Like, seriously, the King of Wands here, something is shifting with this transformation and this tower moment that's happening. This person is becoming an emperor, but there's some heavy manifestation work here. Someone here has had to master themselves. This person has had to master something about this person's mind, them receiving these messages. This person could have a member of the family, like an older gentleman in their family, who was known to have like psychic or spiritual gifts. This person is realizing now that they have it too. I don't know what this is. They could be a medium. This has something to do with, this person may be clairaudient. I'm getting clairaudience. I don't know what it's called. That may be like one of their primary gifts. They can hear all kinds of messages from different things. They also can send you messages clairaudiently. That may not be your strongest gift, but like, this person, they can communicate with you through with something with energy, frequencies. Like, this person, they can, like through music, just through different things. It's something here about frequencies, radio waves or something. This person is very gifted, whoever this is. Like, I don't know. This person may be able to read palms. They could be a psychic medium. They also could be very heavy into manifestation. I don't know, like this person may have for sure like earth and fire in their chart. Very grounded, very stable, very passionate, ambitious. This person can even come off as a little bit aggressive at times because they're very, very passionate about things. And one thing that they're very passionate about, or that they will be very passionate about, is divine feminine. To divine feminine, you pray for this person. You've been manifesting. This is the person you've been manifesting for the last 7 to 10 years. 7 to 10 years, or a karmic cycle in your life had to take place to put you in a position to meet this person or to reunite with this person for some of you. The energy here, it is so intense that it is a little weird that this could be a new person, but some people coming into these spiritual unions, the two of you have been building already in the spirit realm, energetically connected, and the only thing left to do is to meet in the physical plane or to connect physically. But this person rushes in when you least expect it to save the day. You could be, like I said, coming out of some type of toxic cycle, just feeling alone, down, sad, bad. You're in recovery phase right now. You're waiting on God to vindicate you, to redeem you, to restore you. And here comes this person with this King of Wands energy, ready to turn everything around because they're telling you, hey, I'm gonna be your emperor, and I feel like it's time for us to work hard and mastering ourselves so that we can go through a transformation and have this Ten of Cups together. This person is coming in and they want to be all in. Ooh, okay. And look, for some of you, I'm telling you, it's an offer. You don't see it coming. You may have told yourself you don't want an offer from this person. Whatever this is, it's like, I don't think that no is an option. Like, this is it. This is it. I don't know how else to say, like, I know everyone's a free will, but this is who you manifested. This is who you prayed, who you cried, and you slang all this snot for. This is that person. Again, for some, it's someone in your life or someone you're about to meet. But all of the injustices done to you in the past, even since a child or a past life, has been balanced out. Karma has been cleared now. And this person here, they live in your brain. This person has been living in your brain. They've been telepathically communicating with you for a very long time. That's what this is. Yeah. They telepathically communicate with you. And they see that you love yourself, you're self-sufficient, you're abundant, you're secure, you're moving on to peaceful, calm waters. You have victory, success, rewards, recognition for some of you. Like, this person is so proud of you. Now, it's interesting because for some, this also could be like a spirit guide or an ancestor. Because someone is very, very proud of you and they do live, like this person communicates with you constantly, like telepathically. So some of you could be mediums. Because I do have the King of Wands here, the Wheel, and the Emperor. I don't know if this is one person or two. Because I'm picking up the energy of like a passed on loved one, an ancestor or a guide. There's like a spirit guide or someone that's guiding this divine masculine towards this divine feminine. In between these two masculines is the wheel. Destiny. Somebody here has the torch, but it's like they've been given the torch. Somebody here is like, well, we're playing chess, not checkers. But it's something here about this clairaudience and this telepathy. This is a spirit guide. This is divine guidance that someone is receiving But this almost feels to me like a divine feminine and masculine. You are sharing a guide. There's a spirit guide, a passed on loved one, or an ancestor that's communicating with both of you to bring you together. For some of you, this could have been somebody that you walked away from, or you're on the verge of walking away from someone. There could have been a recent breakup for some of you, or you've been separated from this person. I'm not getting, again, in my read, I'm not getting like someone that is super toxic in your life. This is an energy that you could have crossed paths with this person. You could have, you know, dated this person for a short time casually. And it was just like, good person, bad time. Like something like that. But for some of you, for 7 to 10 years, you've been manifesting this type of connection. I don't know what else to say, Harley. I'm very confused. I'm not confused. It's gonna resonate differently for all of you, but this King of Wands and this Emperor, for some reason, I feel like this is two different energies. I feel like there is a spirit guide here. This masculine coming into your life could be someone who is like a psychic medium, or they have some spiritual gifts. They could come from a lineage of very powerful, like shamans or priestess or something like that, where they're now receiving these gifts. But it's like you have a spirit guide, an angel, a passed on loved one, or ancestor. It's like they're letting you know that this person is on the way, or that they're in your life. You're receiving some type of confirmation. So you need to be mindful in your manifestation. You're going to receive very clear confirmation of who your person is. That's for divine feminine, but this divine masculine, I had a reading, another reading. There's a lot of readings coming to mind right now where I talked about an arranged marriage in the spirit. And it's something about marriage. It's almost like a divine masculine has had to get permission from either like your father figure. But for some of you, this father figure is a spirit guide, or it may just be God. Like God has ordained this person for you. That's what this is. Take it how it resonates. For some of you, there's a man, you know, asking your father or father figure for your hand in marriage. Okay, some of you, if your father has passed away, this man is still finding a way to incorporate that into your life together. Okay, if you guys are already in a relationship, someone could be, you know, making sure that they have a tribute, you know, to your father or grandfather on your special day. But for some of you, what I'm, the phrase, this is like your God ordained spouse. This person has been given the torch. They've been given the green light from this very majestic part. The lion represents it's a majestic energy. It is also the leader of the pride, like the male lion, you know, is the protector, the provider. Somebody here has given this King of Wands the okay to come towards you, because I feel like this person actually had to, I always say, this person had to like cross the burning sands to be with you. This person had to prove that they were worthy of this divine feminine. They had to do a lot of work. And divine feminine, you've been praying and manifesting both for, you know, for this person to enter your life or come back, but also protecting them. This person has heard your prayers. They've received the protection. There's a spirit guide, an angel. It's like your whole spiritual team is okay with this. This is your God-ordained spouse. Like this God, your angels, your guides, your ancestors, they're all in agreement of this person being your person. They're coming in with flowers. This is your angel. 100%. Is this, oh my God, like, y'all, I'm seriously about to cry. You fought so hard. For some, you waited on somebody. Could have been 9 months, could have been 9 years. For some of you, you waited on somebody. Or you had to go through something, I'm hearing, that was, it could have been devastating, but now you're free. You're liberated. Like, your soul is, for some of you, oh, okay. So I did a reading a few days ago where I said that there is a generational curse breaker, high priestess, divine feminine coming into union with a legacy building emperor, a masculine. Some of you divine feminine, you're so tired. You are so tired from all of the spiritual work that you've had to do. Y'all, I'm really fighting back tears. You're stressed out. You could be a hopeless romantic, but some of you, you've been losing hope and faith. You were starting to feel like this person just wasn't going to show up. They're coming. Or they're already in your life and they're about to take things to the next level. The offer is here. And I think that you're so tired and burnt out, divine feminine, that you really don't believe it. It's like you've missed so many opportunities that when this offer is presented to you, you really may not believe it. Right now, you're resting, you're retreating, you're recovering. You may feel like you're nesting right now. This is for a reason. If you're feeling tired or like you just need to rest, you definitely could be mentally exhausted. It's okay. It's because God is preparing you for your God-ordained spouse. There's something major. This person is indeed your angel here on earth. This is the earth angel that was created just for you. And with the Knight of Cups being here, again, for some of you, this may not seem like anything too serious. I mean, but this person comes with very pure intentions. They've been like approved. I had a reading maybe 2 weeks ago where I said your new divine counterpart contract has been signed, sealed, and delivered. You can check that out. This is that same energy coming back. Some of you, you cut ties with someone, you ended all of your karmic contracts because it was one-sided situations, you were tired of waiting, you know, some of you, the person that you thought was going to be on your path, they chose to go in a different direction. This person here, they're never going to leave you. This person is going to love you as Christ loved the church. They won't leave you or forsake you. And you don't have to idolize this person. This person, though, I'm telling you, like, you couldn't get this person out of your head if you tried to. Wow. I just really would love to know what exactly is the backstory. I have a playlist about, like, a royal divine couple. You can check that out on my channel if you look under the playlist tab. This energy has been coming out for years. And I feel that for a lot of people, you keep getting close to this person, but there's spell work and manipulation. There's generational curses and hexes. There's so much stuff that has to be done before this union can come. Those things have finally been done. It's like I'm speechless. And I promise I could just like sit on the floor and just cry. Like, I'm feeling the intensity of this. The combination, there's nothing negative out here. Even this devil card, this devil is next to the Two of Cups, but it's not karmic. I feel like there could have been some type, you know what this devil energy here is? This is some type of negative mindset, some type of pessimistic, outdated thoughts, beliefs, fears, or anxieties here that was created for someone in the past. Remember at the very beginning, I was saying somebody is choosing now to not be a product of their environment. Someone could have been taught to live a certain way as a child. You know, when a child, you think as a child, this masculine is now choosing to be very much divine. They're letting go of the lies that they told themselves about their life due to the conditioning. There's a lot of deep healing. This is like, whoa, mind blowing, to say the least. I'm just so like out of this King of Wands with this lion in the background. This is like an ancestor, like an ancient majestic ancestor, or like someone's father, grandfather. It's a spirit guide, though. I don't know. For some, it's an ancestor. For some, it's like a spirit guide. For some, it's a passed on loved one. Definitely could be a father figure. But this person has the green light to come towards you. But you had to master yourself before this person could come towards you. Because the Eight of Swords is here with the Eight of Pentacles. You have to really learn how to compartmentalize your thoughts, I'm hearing. Maybe learn to be a bit more decisive. Learn to not allow yourself to be trapped by fear and illusions. You and this person had to fight to, but this was spiritually arranged, as in it was ordained by God. And your entire spiritual team, they support it. The Devil. Five of Pentacles. Yeah. See, this right here is those outdated beliefs and the fears. Somebody here could have dealt with some type of heartbreak. I said earlier, something traumatizing, possibly from their past. This may not even be this masculine. Divine feminine, for some of you, this could be you. Your mind has not allowed you to actually embrace this type of love, or it's going to be a struggle for you to embrace it because of the abandonment, the rejection, the fears, the anxiety, and everything else, because of all of the deception and the betrayal that you have had to face. And here you have this strength card here. Leo energy. Doesn't have to be Leo, but this is like half woman, half like lioness. And then here you have this. Some of you, as a divine feminine, you have been spiritually guiding this person throughout this entire journey. They're showing up now. Your prayers have been reaching them. There's strong telepathic communication between two people. Your prayers, your healing, everything has been reaching them. For some of you, this is a very old, like ancient type of connection from a past life. For some, like, yeah, this person, they have spirit guides, angels, ancestors surrounding them, but your energy is also guiding this person. Y'all, this is so powerful. Your energy is guiding this person, helping this person to start over. This person can read energy somehow. This person, there's something that they do with their hands. And look, here's the Queen of Wands, which will be the counterpart to the King of Wands. Somebody here could have fire in their chart. Don't have to, but there is a lot of Leo energy here. Leo, Aries, Sagittarius. But this, to me right now, I'm getting twin flame. Power couple. The two of you could be very attractive. That doesn't matter. But you also have learned to shapeshift. So the two of you have some very strong gifts. Okay. I feel like whoever this man is, this man can do something with his hands. He can read energy. He can read palms or something like that. But as a divine feminine, you could be a shapeshifter. Maybe you can energetically shapeshift. I'm definitely picking up something here with like shamanism. You also, somebody here is into some type of fire or candle magic, possibly. You may be into prayer candles. Somebody here could be Catholic because I'm picking up prayer candles. Somebody here is a hermit too. The Virgo, the hermit card is not out here, but I'm picking up hermit energy. Someone has studied a lot, or someone knows a lot about the twin flame soulmate journey. For some of you, you're dealing with a very spiritually aware masculine. They may not have ever said anything about like a twin flame journey or anything, but they know about it. I just heard this person, there's differences here. This person, they're not as well versed when it comes to the twin flame journey, perhaps as you know it, but they know about kingdom marriages. So one of you, and I just said, one of you could be religious while the other is more spiritual. I don't think that that's going to be a problem. But somebody here is aware of kingdom marriages. They see you as their kingdom partner, their God ordained spouse. You may refer to it as divine counterpart or twin flame. They're calling it something different, but they know that the two of you have a purpose to work and to collaborate together. Yeah. Ace of Wands. Somebody's third eye is wide open. Very passionate new beginning here. I'm telling you, like, it's so much passion here. And with the King and the Queen of Wands and this Ace of Wands here, the two of you, it's like a Kundalini awakening or something. It's almost like you and this person, I'm looking at this seven, like you're a chakra system. You're sharing a chakra system. So for some of you, this is a real twin flame. Your chakras and everything with this person, it's like shared. When you heal yourself, you heal this person. When you become enlightened about something, they become enlightened about something. When you think about something, they think about something. When you get sick, they get sick. Oh my goodness. Your life, everything, this is literally your other half. Whoever this is not everyone's story. But for some of you, you really are dealing with or about to be dealing with a true twin. You and this person, like literally you share a chakra system. Your gifts are different. And your views and perspectives are different because you did not live the same life. However, you do share, it's like you share the same soul. This person can do something with their hands. I don't know what it is, telekinesis. Somebody here could be into energy work, reading palms, Reiki. But the Temperance card here, this person, they're an alchemist. They can blend and transmute energies. Temperance Sagittarius makes me think also of like ancient wise shamans, like ancient sages. This person is very, very wise, and it doesn't matter what their age is. The Knight of Cups, this person may come in fun, flirty, young. They don't come off as very serious. This person is like an ancient soul, though. And you really may be guarded towards this person. But the Sun is here. This is becoming healed, enlightened, aware, happy, just like... like you will be just glowing. Your third eye and this person's third eye is like being lit up. It's being shared. So if you have a dream, however they receive their messages and downloads, like I don't feel like you guys receive messages and downloads the exact same way. But the message is being shared. Like your whatever hits your soul is hitting their soul. So if you're under an attack, like a spiritual attack, they know it because they're being attacked too. Eight of Cups. You were able to be freed from some type of conflict, chaos, competition, drama, magic, manipulation, some type of group entity, you know, cult, coven, something that was working against you. You've been freed. You've gotten clearance to walk away from it, or this person has. Yeah, these are a lot of karmic energies that were really trying to hold you back from connecting with this person or taking things to the next level. But I feel like you made it out, and it's taking you right into a union. You had to make a choice. And I feel like what your choice was, are you going to stay and continue to fight with these karmic friends, family, and past lovers? Or are you going to actually take that leap of faith, start over new, and to go towards your true, actual divine counterpart? Many of you weren't doing anything looking for a counterpart. You decided to choose yourself, but by choosing yourself, you're choosing this person because you are them, they are you. Oh my gosh. This is not just soulmates. This is indeed like a twin flame. Divine. I mean, some people's twin flame, twin ray. You and this person, I'm telling you, it's something about your chakra. You're sharing chakra, like. Somebody here, and I do feel that it was a feminine. I feel like the feminine here recently, you said a prayer, you did a, you know, some type of ritual. You know, there could have been something as simple as you lighting a candle, taking a spiritual bath. You could have started doing yoga. You've done something to heal your auric field. And because you now are connected to this person, whatever you did to heal yourself, it healed that person. So, coming now into this new cosmic year, and now being in Aries season, we have a clean slate. It's a new year. Aries, just like the Emperor energy, divine masculine, whatever you've recently done, divine feminine, it helped this masculine. Maybe you decided to protect you and your connection. You may not have even known, because some of you don't know this person yet, not physically anyway. Some type of prayer or protection that you put around yourself and your person, it 100% worked. Some of you, divine feminine especially, you've been under heavy attack. But you now have become this supernatural being. And I had a reading a few weeks ago where I said, for a lot of you, these karmic energies, they can't get you. So now they are doing various things to stop any type of lover from entering your life. You will know who this person is because no matter what spell work, no matter what blockages, delays, this person, they can always come through. This person, it's just like in this card. It's like this person can, I'm telling you, walk on burning sand. You will see this man just about walk on water. Nothing is hitting him. And it's because there's this shield of protection that a lot of the divine feminines carry that is being extended out to your actual divine counterpart. So for those of you who are confused about who this is, What you need to know, especially if you are dealing with this energy of being discontent, bored, and, you know, not really being too optimistic or feeling paranoid, like you don't know who to trust, God in this season is not going to allow too many of the wrong people around you. You have already gotten through that phase, okay? You've already passed those tests and learned those lessons. There's somebody here who, no matter what, they're coming in. No matter how high your guard up, how high of a guard you have up, no matter how much magic other people throw at you, this person, they can handle you at your worst and at your best, because you're this is you. Oh my gosh. Wow. Whoever this is for, this is like really, really amazing. The reading to me, what I'm saying compared to what I'm feeling, the reading doesn't know justice. I'm sorry, I'm stalling. I'm just so shocked to see this show up in this way. I mean, the Ten of Pentacles with the Three of Cups. This is celebrating here. The joining of two people who will have like a real storybook ending, like happily ever after, celebration, wedding. And this is something that will move fast because it's destined. The Eight of Wands and the Star. Once this comes into your life, it's going to take off fast, but it's like, you've been manifesting security, stability. You may have all of that, and the one thing you've been waiting on is love, divine feminine. It's like you have this victory. You're receiving rewards, recognition, success in your life. I feel like everything in your life is pretty much going well because you accepted the call to move away from the conflict and the chaos in your life to go towards peaceful, calm waters. That's the reason why you're resting and you're retreating right now. God is saying you need to recover. This is your season of recovery. As you need to rest up because you're about to be restored and redeemed. Like your vindication, your redemption, restoration, it's all coming. But it's going to hit you so fast, like you're not going to know what happened. There's a divine masculine who's doing some very deep-rooted healing here. This person here, for some of you, like I said, it's something about their childhood or their past. They're hiding here. Somebody here could have had to handle a legal situation. Okay, just to be honest. But I feel like this is someone who they wanted to make sure that they handled everything in their past before they made an offer to you. That's for some of you. For some of you, a big secret that this person is keeping from you is the fact that they have spiritual and psychic gifts that are very powerful. Oh my God. Because I'm picking up on this. This person, for some of you, they have spiritual gifts. They didn't want you to know. This person may have known that you were suffering. Suffering in silence. And what I'm getting is this masculine, I just heard him say, if she would have known that I knew so much, she would have run from me. He said, she likes to think that I don't know her. So divine feminine, you feel safe not being fully seen because of your scars. This person, they already know. I hear him laughing. She likes to think I don't know her. This person knows everything about you. And look at these again. It's something about your shock. I'm telling you, it's something about your chakras. this person does something with energy, or you do. They know, what are these here? This person knows childhood issues, root chakra, heart chakra, they know. Solar plexus, they know. They could have even known that some of you, there's been groups and people collaborating, teaming up to work against you to drain your energy. This person, they're aware of everything. I feel like if this person is in your life, this person literally was like a divine protector sent to you. They came to you very casual. God put this person in your life to protect you. This person knows everything about you. It's a divine feminine out here who is very gifted. Sweetheart, you have truly met your match. And this man, his spirit is so beautiful, because for him to have this type of knowledge, this information, this type of, he does not use this in the wrong way. I can't say all the gifts that he has, but to have these type of gifts and not be trying to destroy you, you have to know the favor that this man has with God over his life. But he was sent to you. You and this person, your life starts when you meet one another. This man could do anything in the world if he wanted to with his gifts alone. He's so humble. He literally is God sent. He's so humble. And for some of you that resonate with like the passed on father figure, this person was sent in to protect you. It's like your whole spiritual team, they're aware of this toxicity going on around you. Because all of this good energy, and then it's kind of like boom. But look at this. Check this out. You have this Two of Cups here, and then the Five of Pentacles. This partnership came into you. This earth angel came into you at a time that you were perhaps at your lowest, your weakest, full of deception, heartache, pain, betrayal. Your chakras was practically blown out. You could have been having financial hardship. And also keep in mind, the roles could be reversed. This masculine could have met, this could, the roles could be reversed. This could be a masculine who ran into an earth angel. However it resonates, somebody was sent an angel, literally from God, to protect them, that they will have a whole life and legacy with. Someone's divine counterpart was, and I have another reading about that. I told you, for some of you, you and your person, you were not actually like scheduled to meet. Until you actually got through some healing. But I feel like the way that these groups and these entities and the devil, the way that you was being like spiritually attacked, this person had to be sent in. For some of you, this person, you may not be dealing with them. This person has to be very close to you. I'm getting like the image, like this person, like they just dropped out the sky. Where you're just like, where did you come from? You were being, like, they were trying to destroy you in the spirit. And I feel like this father figure who could be passed on, spirit guides, angels, ancestors, they was like, we have to send somebody. There has to be someone in the physical realm close by to help either this feminine or this masculine. Because now I'm picking up, for some, there's a masculine out here who was suffering, and a divine feminine you've had to cross paths. But again, for some of the divine feminines, you were already sent to a person as their earth angel. They betrayed you. That's where all of this hell is coming from in your life, because you were already sent to someone as an earth angel. They rejected you and then rerouted you and put you on the path now, where you now need an earth angel to come in and protect you, because these people who rejected you in the past, these are the ones who are in the background causing all of these issues for you. So this is your good karma coming back in the form of an earth angel. Why? Because you were sent to many people as an earth angel. They rejected you. And I've said so many times on this channel, be very careful not to judge a book by its cover. You guys are looking at somebody and you think that they're just like, oh, just, you know, somebody cute, fun, flirty, whatever. This is a whole angel. I tell you guys, angels don't walk around wearing wings. And those who are royal, you don't see their crown. Every single thing is a test. God is testing you now, or will be testing you with this person when they come in your life, to see, will you judge them and will you reject them the same way that people judged and rejected you in the past? Watch what I tell you. Because a lot of you were rejected in the past. You were sent to people as earth angels and they rejected you. They thought that you were a joke. You was a knight. They didn't see you as a queen or a king, a high priestess, an emperor. But that was what was always there. God wasn't going to allow people to see all of your value, because he knew certain people would take advantage of you. And they did. Imagine if you would have had the value that you have now. They would have drained you. They're still trying to drain you. But we don't care to talk about those people. That's old news. Point is that now you have a brand new start. You and this masculine have been working together in the spirit. But this person, either they're in your life now, or they're like very close. I'm talking about, like, this person may live in your neighborhood. You may find that this person they recently relocated, or you recently relocated, or something. Like, they're very, very close. It's like this person, they've been placed in your life strategically. Like, they had to be in close enough proximity to be able to read your chakras, to be able to read you, because I'm telling you, it's like if you get hurt, they get hurt. And this person, whoever, they know their purpose. So it's sort of like, well, wait a minute. I have to hurry up and get to wherever this divine feminine or masculine is, because if they get hurt, it's over for me. You and this person, you have to do everything. See, I'm telling you. I'm seeing like the scene in The Notebook. This is the kind of connection. You and this person, you will take your last breath together. And some of you, since you were between the ages of 7 and 10, and you were thinking about true love before you even really knew what it was, all the way up to the last 7 to 10 years of you possibly waiting or whatever, waiting for this type of love, it's going to be everything that you thought it was supposed to be, and so much more. You and this person literally are one. And the only thing that concerns me about this reading is the fact that the divine feminines are so tired. Or there's a divine masculine here who is so worn out from this journey. But this huge ending is preparing you for this grand new beginning. And it's going to happen fast. Like, really, really fast. Wow. Anything else, Spirit? Hold on. I don't know whose story. This is not everyone's story. I hope that everyone can experience this, but this is not everyone's story. Law of attraction. You and this person, you manifested one another. But you didn't have to do much of anything. It's your God-ordained spouse. This person was created for you and you were created for them. This is like the male version. If you're a divine feminine, it's just your counterpart. It doesn't matter Nothing matters. It's an energetic match. And I do feel like there's differences here. There could be a difference in background. There could be a difference in religion, race, culture, age. But you and this person, it's like on the 3D, you're different. On a soul level, you're the same person. Pleasure. I'm seeing somebody say, well, it's a pleasure to meet you. But this person knows you. I don't know what this is. I'm also seeing like this person, for those of you who resonate with you being very gifted and you meeting a person who has not shared with you that they're very gifted, they're going to reintroduce themselves to you. Like, yeah, that was me. You're gonna be like, yeah, something was moving around in my room. And they're like, yeah, that was me. But yeah, you know, someone was coming into my dreams. I'm like, yeah, that was me. This person eventually is gonna tell you that they know about your journey. But there's gonna be a lot of pleasure, a lot of romance between you and this person. Oh my goodness. It's something about this, it's something about your chakra systems. There's a pleasure point, and this is not, this has to be something like with the Kundalini or something. It's like something is gonna, it shoots through your body. I'm telling you, there's no way you will be able to deny this person. Peace of mind, yeah. There's pleasure. There's a peace of mind here. You and this person, no matter how much stress you deal with, this is your safe haven. You and this person, you can just relax and love one another. Yeah. So here's checkpoint. Some of you, like I said, this person, they could already be in your life and it's time to have a conversation like, okay, what are we doing? Because I feel like someone here has really been sort of pretending like they don't know the importance of this connect. There you have it, proposal. I'm getting to where for some of you, this person, there won't be a, like they're gonna skip the whole, for some of you, it's gonna move so fast. It's not gonna be like a full blown relationship. This person, they just know. This person may just come in and just say, listen, we just need to get married. And you'll be like, what do you mean? Like, don't you think we need to talk about this or we need to discuss this or something like that? And they're like, no. That's why I was saying earlier, like for some of you, this person, you may be asleep or taking a nap because you and this person, you're each other's safe haven. And they may just be like, I think we should get married. You're like, ha ha ha. They're like, no, seriously. Let's go to the courthouse Monday morning. You're like, what? They're like, no, we really need to make this official. And you're like, but we're not, I'm hearing somebody say, well, we're not in a relationship. This person is saying they don't want to be in a relationship. They want to be married. This person is saying they want to be under the covenant of like a holy matrimony with you. This is someone who is very marriage-minded. Again, for some of you, this person could be somewhat religious. I don't know if for some of you, if you slept with this person or not. I'm getting for some of you, if you have slept with this person, this may be the type of person, like after proposing, they may want you to wait. Like begin like abstaining and waiting until your wedding night. It's somebody here is very, very connected with God. They're very obedient. I'm telling you, somebody's like, let's skip the relationship. We just need to get married. For some of you, this person has been around you in your life for a while. It could be like a friend of yours, like a platonic relationship, just, homeboy, homegirl type situation. They're like, hey, I think we should get married. You're like, what? Communication. There's a communication on the horizon where someone is about to express themselves very soon. Reconciliation. I just said very soon, and here's a card that says very soon. Very soon, this person wants to express to you that they want to build a future with you. Very soon. They're going to propose the idea of you guys either going into a very serious, committed relationship. And I'm telling you, if you agree to be in a relationship with this person, they are going into a relationship with the full intentions to marry you quickly. Some of you, the person want, they're already in your life. This is like a friend. For some, it could be an ex-lover, and they're like, listen, let's just skip all of the relationships, so let's just get married. This person, like, they already see everything with you. This person's like, well, we're gonna be together forever. We don't need to, our whole, the whole marriage or relationship will be dating. And I am seeing for some who resonate more with, especially, like, I don't know, for those many of you who may, of course, be Christian, somebody here may not want to engage in premarital sex. They may want to kind of hurry up and get married. Now, I will say too, for some of you, you may be very self-sufficient and abundant right now. A lot of this nesting energy that you're in, some of you and this person, if you are of childbearing age, you and this person, you will indeed procreate together quickly. And it's what they want. In fact, it's what God wants. Yep, here's the Page of Cups. Now, what's interesting is the Empress isn't out here. I feel like Divine Feminine right now, you're just completely off the grid. Off you, like you're just resting. Some of you are traveling, you're resting, you're not really thinking about this. And this person is like sitting down, planning out a whole proposal. Y'all, listen, look at what just fell out. Four of Wands. Somebody is coming in to propose a very serious relationship. They may say that they think the two of you should move in together, they may want to go on a really nice vacation. This person is wanting to build with you. Now, and that looks different for every person. Some of you, this person, they want to start a business together. They may want to live with you. They want to travel. This person wants to do life with you. Just whatever that means for you and for them, that's what they want. I'm hearing, this is like a throwback song, but I'm hearing it ain't none of your friends' business. What you and this person do, most people, they're not gonna understand it. You may wanna keep this to yourself. It's not your friends' business. It's not your family's business. I can guarantee you, with what I'm seeing here, this type of connection and the things that the two of you are going to build, as well as the favor that is on your life with this person, because both of you are very much anointed, nobody is going to be in agreement with how you choose to live with this person. This is one of those things where you're just gonna have to keep your business to yourself, and people, they will just see the love, the relationship, and the beauty in your connection, but nobody's gonna agree with this. The world. Two of Swords, yeah. You're gonna have to walk by faith and not by sight. What you see is not what you get. And what you see, you may want to reject it at first glance for some of you. But this connection is one that can elevate you in so many ways. Yeah, but you just have to tap into your feelings. Let go of the emotion, the illusions here, and allow yourself to just flow. What's so beautiful about this is you see here the moon, the queen of cups, then you see the king of swords and the empress. I'm going to tell you how I know that this is for sure like a yin and yang type of energy. There's a divine feminine out here who has not been completely in their feminine energy because of all of this heartache, pain, hardship, and sorrow. Your divine feminine, your emotions allowed you to buy into a lot of illusions at some point. This person comes in with logic, structure, and order. This puts you in your most feminine energy. With this person, you don't have to think for them. This is why I keep getting this the merging of these chakras. I'm pretty sure too, if you and this person were to put like your birth charts together, one of you, most of the energy in your chart is feminine. Their energy is all masculine. So if you're a divine, like the elements that are feminine will be water and earth. Masculine will be air and fire. This person could be like an air sign and of course have fire in their chart. They are an action person. They're a doer. They're a thinker. This divine feminine, you of course may be Queen of Cups, the Empress. You're creative, you're caring, you're thoughtful, you're an empath. You know, you will cry. You have to feel things to make decisions. You and this person go together like two peas in a pod because what you lack, they have, and vice versa. That's the reason why there's this integration happening. Your chakra systems are colliding. They're merging together. So what you may have been missing was logic. Now that your chakras are merging with this person, divine feminine, you're now becoming more logical. That's the reason why now it's easier for you to get out of these situations with people who are causing you issues. Because your mind, you're not operating only out of your heart space. You're making head over heart decisions now. And then this masculine who could have been dealing with things from their past, they're choosing now to no longer be so hard and so logical, being a product of their environment. Now they're getting into their feminine energy. Their heart is guiding them out of this mindset that they can't love, or that boys can't cry, men can't cry. Like, they're coming out of that, so it's opening up their heart space. Your perception is changing here. And if you notice on this card, it's like the yin and yang. See, you are having a different, your understanding of feminine and masculine energy is changing for a lot of you, because now this connection is going to make a lot of divine feminines and masculines clear away any of your distorted feminine or masculine energy. Wow. What is this? Reunion of souls. I cannot make this up. Literally, reunion of souls. Wow. Joy. My goodness. Self-love and grounding. So as you begin to forgive yourself, your family, ground yourself, love yourself, release all toxic traits, habits, and patterns, something happened. I don't know what type of protection, what kind of manifestation, healing, something happened, and it just, like, something just came over you, and you sent the signal out to this person, and they instantly got it. If some of you have, so I feel like I've been talking to more people lately who actually has a person in their life. It could be in the early stages for some of you. You may notice that, like, this person overnight, it's like they're a different person. Because this energy to me, it seems like a very quick, like, shift. But it's a permanent change. This is not just like, oh, you know. This isn't like some type of in and out, back and forth energy. It's something brand new. It's grounded. It's stable. And it doesn't matter how many options or illusions. This person is choosing you. All you have to do for the divine feminine, all you have to do is be free, be vulnerable, and accept this. That's it. Oh my gosh. Like, what else is there to say? I'm just so blown away right now. And the energy is so, like, peaceful, so calming. Yeah. Any type of juggling, power struggles, ups and downs, emotional instability, financial instability, you're moving past all of those challenges. Somebody here was moving slow because this connection took time, because all of the karmic debts and the baggage from the past life or from past partners or whatever, that has to be cleared away. And now the divine channel is open. Your signal to this person can be heard wide and far. Like, it's no secret that you have a person. This union or reunion of souls, it can't be denied. Wow. This really blew me away. Yikes. I don't have anything else to say. Somebody out, whoever this resonates with, you are incredibly blessed. And you should be so proud of yourself for reaching this point in your journey. This took a lot of hard work. You don't connect with supernatural, magical beings every day like this. A lot of you are soups. You're supernatural, you're divine, you're chosen. And many of the people that you've been with, they were called, but perhaps they are not chosen because they didn't choose to be of the light. I felt like a lot of people who resonate with being like in that high priestess energy. Again, many of the people that you encounter in life will be very spiritual and gifted like you. But this person that I'm picking up on in this reading is a type of person, they're not judgmental, they're not materialistic, they're not superficial, and this person is beyond anointed. This person can move mountain, like a mountain, with their hand. It's something about their energy that is so powerful, and I'm telling you, you would never know. I have a friend who always says, uses the term quiet billionaire. That's what this energy gives me. The type of person, no matter how many riches they had in the world, you probably wouldn't know it, but even if they were never wealthy, this person is so spiritually rich. They're so favored by God. Like, but God has given this person the gift of their counterpart, of a spouse. This union, it unlocks a lot of like a person's like complete birthright, life purpose, spiritual inheritance, wealth. It's the union, the reunion of these souls that it unlocks everything. It literally, it's like someone's life purpose. This partnership, it's a part of it. It's tied into it. Some of you, you're going to be known for having businesses, or you're going to be known as the mother or father of a very, very incredible person one day. Well, to get to the point, you have to be with this person and you have to actually have this baby or start this business. This is your gateway into your like life purpose, your birthright. This person holds the key. It's like while this person was crossing the burning sands, they literally had the key to unlock your heart and your entire chakra system around their neck the whole time. Like this person has been guarding this key to your heart with their life. And I feel like you have too. It's just been so much confusion because most people felt like they had already met their person. For a lot of you, whoever you thought was your person, it wasn't. This is your person. They could already be in your life, but for a lot of you, the majority, the person that you have felt for the last decade was your person. You will know that it's not your person when you meet this person.